It's Professor Dave. Let's look at Saturn.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just looked at Jupiter and its strange moons. So now let's look at the sixth planet from the Sun, Saturn, which turns out to be quite similar to Jupiter in a lot of ways. Saturn is the Roman name for the Greek god Cronus, who was the father of Zeus and other gods. So what can we say about this father of kings? First, let's note that we are getting very far away from the Sun. While Jupiter was a little more than 5 astronomical units away from the Sun, or 5 times as far as Earth, Saturn is already almost 10 astronomical units away, or almost twice as far as Jupiter is. It's also very large, nearly as large as Jupiter, and even less dense. Less dense than water, in fact, which means that, quite incredibly, if there were an ocean large enough, Saturn would float on it. This indicates that it is largely comprised of gases, like hydrogen and helium. Under the thick outer layer of gas, there is a layer of helium droplets around a solid metallic layer, and a relatively small core at the center, just like Jupiter's, made of iron, rock, and water. Ammonia gas forms clouds near the surface that obscures the activity below, which is why Saturn appears to be much smoother than Jupiter. But beyond all this lies Saturn's most striking feature, its prominent ring system. These are thought to be remnants of the cloud of gas and dust that initially formed the planet, though there are competing hypotheses that require the rings to be much younger. Some say the rings are comprised of debris from moons that entered within Saturn's Roche limit, which in this context refers to the radius within which a moon will be torn apart by the gravity of its planet. Although more generally, this term applies just as well to any smaller body orbiting a larger one, like a planet around a star. In any case, the rings extend out to more than twice the planet's radius, but are only a few hundred meters thick, which is incredibly thin by astronomical standards. Although they appear continuous from afar, they are actually just swarms of small icy particles, ranging in size from a grain of sand to a school bus, orbiting at different velocities depending on their distance from the planet. There are gaps in the ring system that have formed due to complex gravitational interactions amongst the particles, as well as some of the more closely neighboring moons. Speaking of moons, Saturn has lots of them, just like Jupiter does, so Saturn looks like yet another mini solar system within the solar system. There are at least 62 of them orbiting roughly within the equatorial plane, and most of them have names derived from Greek mythology. By far, the largest of these moons is called Titan, made of ice and rock. It is the second largest moon in the solar system, after Jupiter's Ganymede, and also slightly larger than the planet Mercury. It is relatively far from Saturn, and is thus rather cold, able to maintain an atmosphere, being one of only 2 known moons to have one, and this atmosphere is composed largely of nitrogen. Clouds rain down liquid hydrocarbons like methane and ethane, making Titan the only body in the solar system other than Earth to clearly have bodies of liquid on its surface. The Titans were the race of Greek gods directly descended from the first primordial gods, and for this reason, Saturn's largest moons have names taken from these Titans. The next largest after Titan and on either side of it are Rhea and Iapetus. From there, the moons get smaller going inward, with Dione, Tethys, Enceladus, and Mimas. Enceladus, which is similar to Europa, exhibits geyser activity, making it the smallest known geologically active object in the solar system. The Cassini spacecraft took pictures earlier in this century of Enceladus spouting plumes of water and organic materials high above its surface. For this reason, it is believed to hold a vast subsurface ocean, ripe with the conditions necessary for life to exist. Beyond these seven moons, there are 55 more, but they are extremely small, negligible in mass compared to the larger ones. And with that, we have a solid picture of Saturn and the Saturnian system. So let's move on to the next planet on the list. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.